Hello beautiful people, I am DJ from Indian Cooks and Books and welcome back to my channel. Today I am coming to you in the night time, so no good morning but good evening, and I thought I'll have a little drink with you guys. Fancy a drink with me? So I'm just going to make a wonderfully weird pink lemonade of sorts. So there are some pomegranate seeds and two tiny lemon lime flavored popsicles, and I'm just going to pour some sparkling water on top and see if it turns into lemonade. I hope it does. Okay, looking good. It's looking good. Cheers, guys. Not bad. Look, it looks interesting, right? Yeah. So that's the drink for tonight. And today we are going to talk about romance. Let's get started right away. So the first book I want to talk about is The Kiss Quotient by Helen Huang. First, let me talk about the good things about the book. It is own voices. It is Vietnamese American. The author also writes about the main character, who is autistic, and while researching, I think she also discovered that she might be on the spectrum too. So it's own voices, it's pretty good. The familial relationships in it are portrayed nicely, but the romance part was really terrible for me, at least. So it's a story of a woman who is successful in IT sector. She is rich, she is successful, but she doesn't have a lot of experience in the romance department. So what does she do? Like a very rational person, she hires an escort, a male escort, to teach her the romance, love, and then they fall in insta-love. It was too insta-lovey, and on paper it sounds fine, it's good. Another good thing is that she's richer than the guy, and the guy seems like a good person, patient, very nice, not toxic. All the good elements that should have made a good story, they don't, because they just don't communicate well. Like when they have given you massive hints, like they have, each of them, they give each other massive hints that they like each other, but they don't get it. They are like, no, I can't be loved and blah blah blah. I can understand up to a certain level, but no. And he takes her home. He takes her to meet his mom, his siblings, everybody. And she still thinks that she's not good enough for him. Like, I mean, what kind of escort will do that for a client if they haven't actually fallen in love with them? It's ridiculous. Also, another thing is he seems to be the more logical one. He's a little more good with people. Then why is it so bad with her? He could have articulated it very well, like properly. Then why doesn't he? It's just all like messed up. They could have just like, maybe if it were up to me, maybe they could have gone on these escort dates and then later on maybe figured out that they have some more feelings towards each other. Then maybe one of them might have like talked about it and the other one might have kind of drawn back. They might have thought about it like, I can't cross that line, hesitate, but they also feel the same thing, and then eventually some loan sharks come and threaten to like confiscate stuff and all that spicy stuff, and then boom, they end up together. That could have been a better story, but it doesn't happen like that. So I am not a big fan of this one. Another one that I'm not a big fan of, I thought maybe I will read a male-male romance then. And I read History Is All You Left Me by Adam Silvera. Adam Silvera is very well known and everybody just loves him, his books apparently. But I tried it and I did not like it at all. So the story goes like, Griffin's ex-boyfriend Theo dies in an accident. He has gone to college. Griffin is still in the senior year of high school. They are in two different states. Griffin has broken up with his ex-boyfriend before he moved out, and the ex-boyfriend started a new relationship before he died in an accident. So he's grieving. We start from where he's numb and he can't process the death of his ex-boyfriend, who he still has feelings for. Then his ex-boyfriend's new boyfriend comes into the town to attend the memorial service, which is fine. And they bond over how they kind of each have a missing piece from Theo's story. On paper, again, it sounds really nice, this idea. It doesn't sound like a YA, even though it is a YA story. It sounds more adult, and the execution is very YA. So much angst and so much pettiness. And it's like there is a group of friends in which these two people are, like, of three people. And the third person, his story is so randomly, abruptly, like, left like a plot hole. Like, there is no closure to his story. They have drama between themselves, the three of them, and only these two people, because one of them dies, their story is told, but the third person is a loose end, which is also fine. But it's very, very clunky. The writing is very clunky. The story goes from back and forth from past and future, and it's very clunky. I did not enjoy the writing style at all. One more thing, there is this discrepancy about immature Griffin and very mature Griffin, and that could have been a good contrast. That could have been a good thing to experience, but it's not. It's just too unnaturally narrated, so I did not like it at all. So these are my two things that I wanted to rant about. I'm still looking for things that I like in romances. I don't know, but maybe I'll pick up a couple of romance novels in future and talk about them. Maybe you guys can tell me some elements that you like or enjoy, or some elements that you do not enjoy in romances, and we'll solve this mystery of love. So hopefully you enjoyed my rant a little bit. It wasn't a big rant, maybe a tiny rant, mini rant, and I hope you had fun. I hope you had a good Friday night. Mine is like okay, going okay. I hope you had a fun Friday night and have a good weekend too. I'll see you next week. Until then, bye-bye. Take care.